I've kind of been an adrenaline junkie my whole life. I worked on lobster boats and cell phone towers. Lobstering, I was offshore. Climbing cell phone towers, I was working at heights. So the two kind of combined.
I like being outside. You get to get your hands dirty or put your feet in the mud to go build something tangible.
I was going to be a lawyer. And honestly, I probably should have explored other opportunities before I did that.
My name is Gabriel Stearns, Union Millwright.
My name is John Burgos. I'm a millwright with Millwrights Local 1121.
I'm Natalie MacDonald. I work with the Piledrivers at Local 56.
My name is Paul Collins. I'm a millwright for about 8 years, and I love it.
A millwright is an industrial mechanic.
Basically, our job involves a lot of rigging and mechanical connection.
We're kind of like a Swiss Army knife of mechanics.
Piledrivers do deep foundation work. So on the water, we drive piles down to foundations for the turbine tower.
Today, we're at a training facility at Mass Maritime Academy. They're teaching us how to handle the worst case scenarios.
Working in a wind turbine requires the ability to climb, and there are hazards that go with that. So the very first day of GWO training, they cover working at heights.
We get shown how to use three different ladders with three different connection types. That's useful because we do use them offshore, and not having seen them before, you show up and you're like, oh, I know what this is.
We're pretty much our own first responders out there. You can call for help, but it's going to be a while. So you're putting each other's lives in each other's hands.
We have them simulate evacuating from a nacelle or the top of the wind turbine. They connect to the emergency escape device, open a hatch, and descend down what in real life would be hundreds of feet to safety. Then we take those same skills and now we do it out on the water. And whatever temperature is in Buzzards Bay that day, that's what they're going into.
We're doing the sea survival, how to wait for help, how to get in the life raft.
We'd show them different positions to help collectively preserve body heat. And so they really do build confidence.
Biggest safety concern, it's really watching others. You need your buddies because if you're watching them, you know that they're going to be watching you.
Offshore, we are on the sea installer. It houses about 120 crew. We have a little gym, a cafeteria, dorms, which you usually share with someone else. They're nice, cozy little accommodations.
I spend 3 weeks on, 3 weeks off.
I've had rotations that were 4 weeks on, 4 weeks off, but I've also done 5 weeks on, 5 weeks off. So you gotta be ready for a longer stay sometimes.
We work 12-hour shifts, and we put tower sections together. And we have to build the ladders. We have to build all the electrical connections.
Our job is to hook up what is a very large crane and then take components off of a moving barge.
When the tower comes down over the top of us, we have a special machine. It's a computer-run device that stretches the bolts and then tightens them. The base of the bolts, they're about that big.
After 12 hours, you have dinner with your coworkers and do it again the next day. It's our second family, you know, you get close fast.
I really do find that there's a certain level of camaraderie one gains from tasks like this. That gives you an appreciation for the people around you when they help you. Because when they help you in real physical ways.
Working in clean energy means a lot to me. Really feel like I'm making a difference. When I go home, the people around me really respect and honor my work.
It feels great to be pioneering the clean energy revolution. It's rewarding.
If we are diligent, we have an opportunity to avoid the worst. But there is a large generational gap in the trades. We need kids to be doing this.
We need as many workers as we can get. If you've got the drive to want to make a difference, I would definitely look into clean energy.
If you work offshore, you're making 150 plus. You will have a good lifelong career doing this if you are willing.
The unions that are involved in the construction of these projects are a great opportunity to be able to get trained and to earn a very good wage while they're building out this enormous clean energy industry.
It's not going away anytime soon. It's right in our backyard. It's a win-win for everyone.